Yes, there's a muscle there. Today, we're going to talk about the brachioradialis and why it may be an important muscle to you. So, to backtrack a little bit, the reason why we started this series is because we've had a lot of patients come in recently and say, I have pain here. And after we do the testing, realize that it's a muscle that is causing the problem. And they're like, I didn't know there was a muscle there. Well, I mean, there's pretty much mu a muscle like anywhere you're going to touch on your body. And actually, a lot of times there's more than one. And so we're trying to have some conversation around the different muscles in the body and how they may be affecting you. And today we're talking about the brachioradialis. Now, the reason why we're talking about that today is because the brachioradialis is actually an elbow flexor, which means it does that. Elbow flexion. So, like bicep curl, right? Brachioradialis actually helps with elbow flexion or a bicep curl. So, obviously, bicep curl is what we commonly call it, right? Because we assume that the bicep is the one that's doing it, which obviously, yes, the bicep is an elbow flexor too. But a lot of people, and a lot of people know that, right? That's why we call it the bicep curl, because the biceps are working. It's an elbow flexor. But a lot of people don't know about the brachioradialis and how important it is in elbow flexion, allowing normal elbow flexion, and what can be a problem if it's a tight muscle or weak muscle or a damaged muscle or muscle that's not working properly. So the brachioradialis starts on the kind of the end of the humerus here, and it attaches onto the end of the radius right here. And so it crosses the elbow joint, right, which allows for elbow flexion. It most commonly works when your hand is in what we call a neutral position. So if you have your hand up or if you have your hand down, you have less contraction of this muscle. But if your hand's in neutral, you're going to have more activation of the brachioradialis. So actually, in the clinic, when we're trying to figure out which muscle in particular is causing the problem, because I don't like to just say, oh, it's an elbow flexor. I want to know which muscle in particular. Like, is it bicep? Which head of the bicep is most affected? There's different ways to test all these things. So to test the brachioradialis or emphasize it, what we're going to do is we're going to test that elbow flexion with that hand in the neutral position. That biases the brachioradialis. If we have more of a problem there than in other positions, then we know that potentially we have a brachioradialis problem. Of course, we got to look at that in conjunction with all the other signs and symptoms. We've got to hear your story and what you're describing. Obviously, if you're describing pain, up here in your pecs, it's probably not a brachioradialis problem. But it could be affecting, because if you're doing a whole bunch of bicep curls and in neutral and your brachioradialis is not moving correctly, then that could put a lot of strain on your pecs, right? Everything's connected. That's what we say all the time around here. And now you can start to see how it can be connected. But primarily, we're going to be concerned with the brachioradialis when you're having pain right here, kind of on the edge here, and wanting to make sure that we test that muscle to see how strong it is, to see how tight it is, to see if it's the one that is causing your problem. The other thing that's important about it is that there's nerves that run through that muscle. Now, to be fair, there's nerves that run through lots of muscles in your body, but it can cause like numbness and tingling into your hand if the nerve is compressed because of a tight muscle. And so sometimes people will think, oh, there's something going on in my neck. And that can be true. Obviously, something going on with a disc in your neck can cause numbness and tingling in your hand. But also with the nerve running through that muscle, that can cause numbness and tingling in your hand too. So this is why it's so important to do a complete evaluation, right? Anytime we have someone, let's say, who has numbness and tingling in their hand, we need to look through the forearm, we need to look through the upper arm, we need to look through the shoulder, we need to see what's going on with the nerves as they're coming through the front of the shoulder here. And obviously, we have to look at the neck too, because we need to understand exactly where the root of that problem is so we know how to fix it. Because if the root of the problem is in your forearm and we're working on your neck, you're not going to get the results you want. And if the root of the problem is in your neck and we're working on your forearm, you're you're not going to get the results you want. And that's really our goal here, is to help you articulate what it is you want to get back to, and then help get you there just as quickly as we can. So that's the brachioradialis. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video series, and we will be back with another one next month. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.